Zhu Shiming won his pro debut. You just told me 600 million people watched it. What did you think of his performance?
Look, it's a pro debut. What were people expecting? You know, thunder and lightning. They didn't quite get it. But the guy wins a match, and he's bound to win many, 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 many more before I think he's put in a position of anything bad happening to him. Hey, two-time gold medalist, two separate Olympics is pretty noteworthy, not to mention another bronze on top of that in a completely separate Olympics. That's pretty amazing as far as your longevity, as far as you staying on top of the amateur scene and all that type of stuff. So that's some noteworthy.
So why were so many people disappointed online? On the internet, I saw a lot of disappointment.
What were they expecting? Exactly.
They expected a 10-second knockout, a two-minute knockout.
But they would have been just as dissatisfied with that, calling his opponent a palooka, saying that he couldn't even hang 10 seconds with it.
El Azar Venezuela?
Well,
what did you call him?
I think
palooka.
A palooka.
What's that?
That's a bum.
In what language?
That's Polish.
How am I supposed to know Polish? What am I, Thomas Adamek? Okay.
Anyways, look. You're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't. I think if you're this Chinese guy, no way can you live up to the hype of the three medalist Olympian, you know, the next Asian sensation. So he was never going to live up to those regardless. So the guy goes out there, he looks flashy, he looks slick, he wins a decision. Nobody's happy because he didn't knock the guy out. If he would have got rid of the guy in 30 seconds, nobody would be happy because they say he was just in there with a bump. So very difficult situation for this guy. Regardless, 600 million Chinese watching, and not to mention how many other millions of Americans and elsewhere watching on HBO. That's a pretty good audience to springboard your career. And as far as the whole card went, I thought it was a good showcase for little guys. I was entertained.
Who do you want to see Zhu Shiming fight next?
Fight next? I mean, in his second pro fight, the guy's gonna have to get used to.
How many fights do you think he needs?
Impossible for me to say with any accuracy, just watching this one fight, not knowing him in the gym or anything like that. I think he can be moved pretty quickly, but even if you got to think, what's as quick as it gets, like a Guillermo Rigan challenging for a title and like...
It's different. The Cuban style and his style is so different because his hands are down, he's open. Where Rigan Dao is like a little, like, he's like armadillo, you can't hit him. And he has that body too. It's different styles.
It's also different weights, you know. You're not going to have as many big, big hitters, I think, at 112 for Zhu. And I'm sure he'll feast mostly on Asian fare in the beginning of his career, at least. And as far as a potential fight down the line, I know they were hoping maybe to keep Veloria's title alive, but he lost. So I don't know. You got to build somebody up at 112 to make an attractive match. And that's when these type of things happen. As Zhu is starting his pro career, trust me, his handlers are prepping their big money opponent to be ready in whatever due time they have mapped out. 6 fights, 8 fights, 12 fights. Trust me, they have somebody else's career following a parallel path to his, so they'll fight in the future.
There you have it, Brandon Krause, Radio Outlaw. Stay tuned, FuseReport.com, Lightstick Back Report. Did you see Zhu Shiming's fight?
Nah.
You heard about it though?
Yeah, Brandon told me about it, so I didn't even know who that dude was.
You gotta watch it. I can't talk to someone who didn't see a fight. Because the comments online did not agree with what Brandon said, but that was his perspective.
What they were saying, that they thought it was a good fight?
Nah, they expected more from him because the hype. Like, they expected to see, you know, lightning and thunder.
But you know, like these gold medalists and all, they never turn out to, you know, what they're supposed to be.
Well,
know?
At 31, it's hard to turn pro. He has talent, but
why did he decide to turn pro so late?
The money. He got $300,000 for his pro debut, $500,000 for his next fight. When you fight at the Olympics, well, if you win gold for a third world country, you could get hundreds of millions or tens of millions. Damn. But here in the U.S., if you win gold, you get $40,000, and that's tax. So it's $20,000 in your pocket.
Yeah, exactly.
So if you're very privileged, you
not
could be in
the Olympics. Not even $20,000, because then you got to pay all your team. Damn, that's pretty.
That's nothing. Yeah. But if you turn pro and you make that kind of money, hey,